Good morning once again and Shabbat Shalom. Once again, it is our privilege to learn Torah with Rabbi Hillel Silverman. Good morning, Hillel. Shabbat Shalom.
Good morning, Rabbi. It's a pleasure to be with you.
Lovely to have you. This morning, we're reading from Parshat Ekev, the Torah portion in the book of Deuteronomy. Tell us about this week's Torah portion.
Well, 2 weeks ago, we began to read from the fifth book of the Torah, Devarim, Deuteronomy. These five books are very, very different. The first one is Genesis, and we read about the creation of the world, Adam and Eve, the Avot, the forefathers, Abraham, Isaac, Jacob, and Joseph. The second book we read in the Torah was Exodus. We read about the Jews in Egypt, the building of the pyramids, Pharaoh, the 10 plagues, the crossing of the Red Sea, the giving of the 10 commandments, the golden calf. Third book of the Torah, of the Chumash, was Leviticus, Leviticus, Vayikra. We read about the sacrificial system and the priests, the Levites. Fourth book was the book of Numbers, the last 38 years or so of wandering in the wilderness. We read of the scouts of Korach, of Balak, of Pinchas. And 2 weeks ago, we came to Deuteronomy. Deuteronomy is a very, very interesting book. We'll talk about it in a moment, but I must go into Bible scholarship. It's fascinating. There are Bible scholars who say that these five books, these manuscripts, were written at different times and then combined together. The documentary hypothesis is called J, E, D, and P. And J stands for the use of Adonai. E is Elohim. D is Deuteronomy. P is the priestly. Four different books, four different manuscripts, maybe even four different times combined together and combined by R, which is redactor, or much better, Rebbe, because the rabbi who can combine the volumes, the five books of Moses, was inspired by God. We call the book of Deuteronomy in Hebrew Devarim. These are the words. Devarim, Deuteronomy comes from the Latin of the Septuagint. The Septuagint was a translation in Greek for the Jews who lived in Alexandria. Deutra nomas, it means the second law. And of course, in Deuteronomy, we have a second written edition of the laws. For example, we have the Ten Commandments in Deuteronomy. The same Ten Commandments were written in the book of Exodus. They're almost identical, but there are some changes. And some of the additions were to the law of observing the Sabbath and honoring your father and your mother. It's interesting with the Sabbath observance that Deuteronomy tells us, Zachor, remember the Sabbath day. And in Exodus, it's keep the Sabbath day. Honor and keep, two different concepts. And of course, we find in the Lecha Dodi, in the Friday night poem that's recited as a prayer, that these two words, Shamor v'Zachor, were uttered in one breath by God, not in two. And our rabbis tell us that they're both important. We must remember that it's a Sabbath day. And many Jews do remember it's a Sabbath as they go about their business, as they drive, as they shop, as they do everything but observe the Sabbath. So we need Shamor to keep the Sabbath, to observe the Sabbath. Let's get back now to Deuteronomy, the four farewell addresses of Moses. They have been in the wilderness now for over 38 years. They are on the verge of entering the Holy Land, and Moses delivers four farewell addresses to the children of Israel. It's as a leader addressing his disciples. It's like a father addressing his children, like a teacher addressing his students, like a shepherd who is caring for his flock. Four farewell addresses of Moses. Our sedra today is Akev. It's a very, very beautiful sedra. It has many, many hints on how we can live a full and happy and creative and a good life. I'm going to share with you three of the observations from this morning's sedra, which we should take to heart. They're very simple teachings of Moses in his farewell addresses. And his farewell address, of course, he not only remembers the incidences of the history of the Jewish people, but he also is giving them admonishments for the future. And the first very, very interesting observation is V'achalta v'saivata v'saivata uverachta, and you shall eat, and you shall be satisfied, and you shall bless the Lord your God. This is the first teaching. It's a teaching of gratitude. One must be grateful. Thank you is a very, very important statement that we should make. For so many of us, we think that the blessings of God are coming to us, that we deserve them, that we take them for granted. The blessing of health, of our family, of our children, of our job, of security, of our home, of the synagogue, of freedom, of the professional help that we receive. We take it for granted. We must every day acknowledge God. You shall eat, you shall be satisfied, and you shall bless, you shall thank the Lord. There are a number of different prayers, types of prayers which we offer. Some are prayers of petition. We ask God for a blessing. Some prayers are prayers of confession. Many prayers are prayers extolling God. But the most important prayer is a prayer of gratitude. Our Talmud tells us that when all of the prayers will be eliminated in the next world, one type of prayer will remain, the Hodayah, the prayer of gratitude. You remember the old song, "When at night I cannot sleep, let me count my blessings instead of sheep." We should count our blessings every day. We should be grateful. Without gratitude, life is meaningless. There was a rabbi whose name was Nachum ben Zalai. In the Talmud, Nachum Gamzu. Gamzu means it's for the best. I accept it. Whatever God does, Gamzu, it is for the best. The Hebrew, uverachta, and you shall praise, you shall bless God. Eat, be satisfied and blessed. If you change one letter from the chav to the chet, the same sound, uvarachta, and you shall run away, you shall escape. Many people eat and are satisfied, and they run away. Let us learn from tomorrow, from this morning's seder, the importance of gratitude. So that's the first teaching tomorrow morning, this morning. The second teaching is Moses tells the children of Israel, when you come to the new land, and you will have many, many blessings from God. You will have water, you will have crops, you will have agriculture, you will have homes, and you will have crops, and you will have corn, and you will have wine. Do not take credit for it. Do not say, "B'kochi u'b'otzem libi," by my strength and by my strength of my hands, I've accomplished this. This is the second lesson, which is a lesson of humility. Pride is the opposite of humility. Let us make let us not take a credit for our blessings. We have a blessed business, we have a job, we have children, we have accomplishments, we have a reputation. Let us not say that we deserve it. It is coming to us. It is coming to us. Humility is a most important trait of character. It has been said that when we have problems, when we have failures, when our family is in trouble, what do? We blame God. But when we have accomplishments, when we have success, when we have credit, when we have security, then we take the credit for ourselves. Let's reverse it. Let's blame ourselves for our problems, and let us thank God for our accomplishments. The Bible praises Moses later in our readings. Now, what does the Bible say, the Torah say about Moses? Did it recall that he was strong, that he was gifted, that he was charismatic, that he had courage? They say Moses was anav ma'od. Moses was very, very humble. That's what we need, is humility, the opposite of pride. So in our Sedra this morning, we learn how important gratitude is. We learn how important humility is. And a final teaching is lo alechem levado. Man does not live by bread alone. We do not live for our money, for our success, for our homes, and for our possessions. These are things. We should not be concerned with things. There is much more to life than material blessings. There is much more to life than success. We all participated in the lockdown the last number of months. We were confined to our homes, and many of us were very unhappy. Many of us were very disappointed. And what did we do? I know what I did, and I'm sure you did too. I read so many books, and I saw so many lectures on television, and I attended art exhibits and museums. Lo al halechem levado. Man does not live by bread alone. We must keep the important teachings of our Sedra tomorrow morning. There is much more to life than money, much more to life than materialistic things. There are spiritual, there are intellectual, there are cultural blessings. And so in our Sedra this morning, Moses tells us, be grateful, be humble, and do not only derive happiness from material blessings. Amen. Shabbat shalom.
Thank you, Rabbi. Shabbat shalom. Wonderful lessons and wonderful learning with you this morning. And I want to wish you blessings of good health and strength, and take very good care.
Thank you very much. It's a pleasure to be with you. Shabbat shalom.
Shabbat shalom.